Chapter 1. Intro.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Hey there, smart home fanatics. Welcome back to the channel where we turn confusing tech into something you can actually use without needing a PhD in rocket science. If you're new here, I'm Nicola, your home assistant, and today we're jumping into the world of smart switches. More specifically, the MOES ZigBee One Gang Smart Light Switch module. Sounds fancy, right? Well, don't worry. I'll break it down step by step so you can install it, integrate it with Home Assistant, and have complete mastery over your home lighting. Oh, and don't forget to hit that like button and subscribe if you love smart home automation as much as we do. Now, let's get into it. But first, a quick disclaimer.
Chapter 2. Quick disclaimer.
Before we go any further, let's address the elephant in the room, or rather, the MOES switch in the room. This video is not sponsored by MOES. It's also not sponsored by Amazon. No one's paying me to say nice things about this switch. No briefcases full of cash were exchanged. No top secret smart home conspiracy meetings were held in dimly lit rooms. Just me, my toolbox, and my ever-growing collection of smart home gadgets. But MOES, if you're watching and want to send over some gear, I wouldn't say no. In all seriousness, I bought this switch with my own money because I think it's useful and I want to show you how to use it. So, let's jump into the installation and setup process.
Chapter 3. What's in the box?
I bought this module a few months ago, in December 2024 to be exact, from Amazon for just £15.29, which, in smart home gadget terms, is practically pocket change. Unless you're trying to automate everything, in which case, well, let's just say our wallets are in this together. So inside the box we've got the MOES ZigBee Smart Switch Module MS-104Z, the brains behind the operation, a mounting clip, because floating switches aren't a thing, yet, a manual, which, let's be honest, no one actually reads. But in this case, trust me, the wiring diagrams will be very useful, or even essential. That's pretty much it. No unnecessary fluff, just what you need to get started. Let's have a closer look at our new toy. The dimensions are 52 by 47 by 18 millimeters, small enough to fit inside a junction box behind a switch. It has 6 terminals. Oh my god, so many? Yet, the manual is a must read here. There's also a reset slash pairing button on the switch. The mounting clip is made of plastic, but it holds the switch module securely in place. It might not be used inside a junction box, but I can see situations where it could come in handy or even be necessary. You'll see examples in future videos. As for the manual, I prefer using the electronic version instead of the paper one. You'll find a link to the English manual in the description below this video. If you need it in another language, check out the MOES website. Now let's move on to installation.
Chapter 4. The Great Wiring Puzzle.
It's time to tackle the wiring challenge. Installation is fairly straightforward, but before we even think about touching a wire, safety first. Turn off the power at the circuit breaker. No exceptions. Electricity isn't something to mess around with unless you enjoy accidental hair-raising experiences. If you're unsure about wiring, do yourself a favor and call a qualified electrician. Let's keep this a shock-free experience. Oh, and remember that mysterious new tool from my video? Today, its purpose will finally be revealed. No more secrets, it's time to put it to use. Enough talking. Less chatter, more action, before someone changes their mind about DIY. Identify your wires. They should be color-coded, but never assume. Double-check the standards in your country. In the UK, since 2004. Live is brown. Neutral is blue. And earth is green and yellow. Find the live and wire. This is the one supplying power. Warning! Unfortunately, this step needs to be done while the power is on. So please be extremely careful. No heroics, just safe and smart testing. The best tool for this is a non-contact voltage detector pen, a must-have for any aspiring electrician. If you don't have one, a simple screwdriver with an electricity detector will also do the trick. Once you've identified the live in wire, turn the power off again, then mark the wire so you can easily recognize it later. Double check everything. Wiring mistakes can lead to short circuits, blown fuses, or in the worst case, an unexpected DIY fireworks display. Safety first, always. If you're feeling confident, everything checks out, and the power is off, let's get this module wired up. I'll be demonstrating three different wiring setups that I personally use in my smart home, each suited to different scenarios. Got a different setup in mind? Let me know in the comments. I'd be happy to cover more. But first, let's get everything ready inside the junction box. Connect all earth wires together. Connect all neutral wires together and add one extra wire. This will later connect to the smart module. With everything prepped, let's move on to the fun part, getting this module connected. Setup 1, no physical switch. This setup is for those fully committed to pure automation. No manual switch, just seamless, smart control bliss via Home Assistant. Refer to the wiring diagram for a visual guide on how to connect the module. The diagram clearly illustrates each connection, making it easy to follow along with the instructions. Connect the neutral wire to N on the smart module. Connect the live out wire to L out. Connect the live in wire to L and L1. Since L has two connectors, use one for live in and the other to bridge L to L1. And just like that, your smart switch module is fully wired without a physical switch. Minimalist, clean, 100% smart. Setup 2, physical switch before the module. In this setup, the physical switch is installed before the smart module. That means Home Assistant can only control the module when the switch is on. If the switch is off, the module has no power, so no smart control. The wiring is almost identical to the previous setup, with one key difference. Instead of connecting live-in directly to the smart module, first route it through the physical switch. Use the COM terminal on the switch for the live-in wire. From the switch's L1 terminal, connect a wire to both L and L1 on the smart module. As before, you can bridge L to L1. Now the physical switch acts as a master power gatekeeper. It can cut off power to the smart module and whatever device it's controlling, leaving Home Assistant completely powerless when switched off. Choose wisely. Setup 3, physical switch in the module. This is the recommended and likely the most popular setup, keeping the wall switch fully functional while allowing Home Assistant to take control. Regardless of the switch position, Home Assistant remains in charge. One important thing to note, you may need to replace your existing light switch. According to the manufacturer, this module is designed to work with rocker light switches or retractive switches, also known as push or reset switches. What are they? A retractive or reset switch is a switch that returns to its original state after being pressed, similar to most doorbell switches. It provides a much smoother experience for smart control, which is why I use it in my home and for this demonstration. What about a rocker switch? Well, I'm not an electrician. Shocking, I know. And I honestly couldn't figure out what defines a rocker light switch or how it's different from a regular switch. I tried. I Googled. I asked ChatGPT. I even consulted a friend who is an electrician. And yet, I failed. Spectacularly. Zena knows the answer, but she's too busy plotting world domination and refuses to share her secrets. Typical. All I know is that traditional switches don't play nicely with this module. If you want me to explain why, drop a comment. I'll happily overanalyze it for you. Check out the wiring diagram. It provides a clear visual representation of how to connect everything, making installation straightforward. Since my retractive switch likes to stay grounded, literally, first connect the earth wires. The next two steps are the same as before. Connect the neutral wire to N on the smart module. Connect the live out wire to L out. Now, here's the important part. Live-in needs to connect to three places. L1, and the physical switch. To make this clearer, I'm using a splicing connector for the live wires. The live input goes into the splicing connector, from which one wire connects to the L terminal on the module and another connects to the switch. As before, you can bridge L to L1. On the physical switch, use the COM terminal for the live and wire. From the switch's one-way terminal, also known as L1, connect a wire to S1 on the smart module. And that's it. Installation complete. This setup allows both the physical switch and home assistant to work together like a dream team. Smart automation when you want it, manual control when you need it. With that, you have successfully wired your ZigBee smart switch module with a physical switch.
Chapter 5, Home Assistant Setup.
Now that the wiring is done, it's time to make some smart magic happen. Flip that breaker back on and take a moment to admire your electrical masterpiece. No sparks? No smoke? No smell of burning regrets? Fantastic! Let's move on before the universe realizes we got away with it. Since this module speaks ZigBee, you'll need a ZigBee-compatible hub to introduce it to Home Assistant. I'm using ZigBee 2 MQTT, so all examples will be based on my live setup. Step 1. Pair the module. Time to introduce your new MOES ZigBee smart switch module to the rest of your smart home. Think of it like online dating, but instead of awkward small talk, you're just hoping the connection works. Open the ZigBee 2 MQTT integration and put your hub into pairing mode by clicking Permit Join. This tells your ZigBee network, hey, we're making new friends. Most ZigBee devices jump into pairing mode automatically when first powered on. But if yours is feeling shy, you may need to reset it. Press and hold the reset button on the module until you hear a continuous beeping sound, the universal sign of surrender. Two beeps are not enough. Keep pressing. If your module is already buried inside a junction box and you don't feel like playing electrician again, try these sneaky workarounds. For retractive switch, press the switch 10 times quickly. For rocker switch, toggle it on and off 10 times. Yes, that's 20 presses total. Get those fingers ready. You should hear a continuous beeping sound, which means your device has entered pairing mode and is searching for its new home. Within a few seconds, your switch module should appear in the device list. If not, take a deep breath, try again, and remind yourself why you started this DIY journey in the first place. Step 2. Give it a name. Unless you enjoy scrolling through a never-ending list of ZigBee IEEE addresses, do yourself a favor and rename your module in ZigBee 2 MQTT interface. I named mine SWM Dining RM Tool. SWM, short for Switch Module, because life's too short for long names. Dining R, because I'm currently testing it in the dining room. MTool, because it's installed in my mysterious tool. If you know, you know. Before hitting Rename Device, enable Update Home Assistant Entity ID so the new name syncs across your smart home setup. Trust me, you don't want to rename it multiple times. For extra naming wizardry, check out my video, The Perfect Naming Conventions. Simplify your smart home. Click the link in the top right corner now or find it in the description below. Step 3. Tweak the settings. Now let's fine-tune some settings so your smart switch doesn't develop a mind of its own. Open the About tab and add a description. This is optional, but future you will appreciate it. I wrote, Smart Switch Module in the Mysterious Tool, now 80% less annoying than before. Open the Settings Specific tab and set State Action to True. This tells Home Assistant when the switch is on or off. Pretty important. Head over to the Expose tab and adjust the Power On Behavior setting. I set mine to off because I don't want my light turning back on after a power outage. This tool is powered off most of the time anyway, and I don't need it plotting against me while I sleep. And boom! Your switch is now a fully functional smart device. Step 4. Assign location and labels. Let's organize like a pro, because even Home Assistant loves a tidy setup. Open Home Assistant settings and go to Devices and Services. Switch to the Devices tab, find your newly paired switch module, and click on it. Tap the pencil icon in the top right corner and assign a room. Living room, garage, the forbidden closet of mystery. Whatever works for you. Add labels to make future automations a breeze. Click Update and you're done. Congratulations! Your ZigBee Smart Switch module is now wired, paired, and fully integrated with Home Assistant. Now comes the moment of truth. Does it actually work? If yes, celebrate accordingly. If not, welcome to the wonderful world of troubleshooting.
Chapter 6, Testing.
Not much testing to do here, but let's do it anyway. Time to see if all your hard work actually paid off. Press the switch a few times. On. Off. Starting to feel like a DJ yet? Mine works perfectly. No flickering, no drama, just smooth, reliable control. Now toggle the switch in Home Assisted a few times. Mine responds flawlessly. Zero issues. How about yours? Working like a charm? Awesome! You did it! Your smart switch is now officially smarter than your ex's excuses. If something isn't working, take a deep breath, recheck the wiring, and remember, even the best hackers have to debug. Either way, you're now one step closer to a fully smart home.
Chapter 7. Thank you.
Mission accomplished. Your smart switch is installed, tested, and officially part of your smart home empire. Welcome to the world of effortless lighting control. Huge thanks for sticking around until the end. You've got the patience of a saint, or at least an electrician. If you found this guide helpful, or at least mildly entertaining, don't forget to like, subscribe, and drop a comment below. Did your setup go smoothly, or did you have an exciting troubleshooting adventure? Want me to cover more wiring setups? Was this guide clear and easy to follow? Let me know in the comments, I read them all. At least for now, since there aren't too many, so I don't have to spend hours scrolling. Now go enjoy your new smart switch, because manually flipping switches is so last century. Thank you again. If you'd like to support this channel, feel free to donate a penny or two. Every bit helps. All links are in the description. Stay safe, stay awesome, and happy switching!